Hey there, interwebs. Welcome to Handbasket Streaming. I am Adam, and today we're playing Zelda Breath of the Wild. Actually, I talked about this on an episode that hasn't aired yet. The way we're going to do this is I'm going to focus on story quests and stuff during the episodes, and focus just on getting shrines during the not episodes. So I'm up here on this mountain. I'm going to talk to this guy.
Very impressive. Not many could make it up here in such rain.
It was easy. I can swim up waterfalls.
I'd expect no less from a well-worn traveler like you.
What are you trying to say?
Me? I stay nice and dry. My feathers repel the rain rather well. And my instrument was designed to withstand extreme moisture.
Ooh, off to a good start today.
When your livelihood revolves around ancient songs, you've got to be prepared for a few raindrops. I know a song about this place. Would you like to hear an ancient verse passed down about this region?
Let's hear it.
Excellent. Without further ado.
When a lost hero calls down
lightning from the sky, the monk responds from a giant mound on high.
There's a puzzle in this somewhere, but as far as I can tell, it could apply to a great many things.
No, I think it's really just the one thing. Hey, Nick, yes, it definitely is. This game is entirely worth the price tag of the Switch.
Anyway, may the light shine ever on your path.
So, that quest, in a nutshell, is I have to strike this thing with lightning. Yeah, where's my box? There's my box. This box was hidden under the water. And this is interesting. When I was playing this on my personal game, what I did was I stood my ass on top of the mound and got struck by lightning, much like that. So, yeah, that went well. But this time around, I happen to notice that there's a magnetic box in the water nearby. Now I just get up. Oh, no! Mistakes were made. Stop. All right, we're fine. Everything's fine. But yeah, this is a much smarter way of, striking this thing with lightning and not having to nearly die in the process. Yeah, that's the other thing. Earlier this week, I actually beat my personal game and took down Ganon and whatnot. And, you know, it was far from a completionist playthrough. So I decided that, you know, provided anybody enjoys watching the stream, I'm just going to make this playthrough the completionist stream, or completionist playthrough, and do my best to get all the things. Maybe not all the Korok seeds, because there are 900 of them, but I'll at least shoot for all the shrines. Yeah, so fun times. I love the little, like, I love the shrines. Oh, I was about to say, they're always interesting, they're always little puzzles and whatnot, and this one's just, the puzzle was getting into the shrine. Rubber tights. Sure. Why not? And boom goes the dynamite. Give me your ghost ball! Yep, did well. Ghost ball, thank you. Cool. So yeah, in between the last time I recorded this and the stream today, I went around and gathered up a handful of towers and a bunch of fast travel points for shrines, so at least until I run out of those, it's going to be a quick, you know, jump from shrine to shrine to shrine to shrine, boom, 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 and that'll be nice because then I can get some freaking hearts and not die quite so often, because it happens a lot. And that's one of those where it's been very frustrating trying to do prep work for the stream because I'm trying to, you know, trying to stay true to the continuity as best I can, meaning I haven't gotten any shrines, and therefore I haven't gotten any hearts, and I've died a lot. Like, most notably, there's a tower that's surrounded by electric whiz robes, and that's just... that's bad news bears. Where am I going? That's the other thing, I've been using the shrines as fast travel points so often that I forgot to go inside. But yeah, I love the ever-loving hell out of this game. Like, it is... like, my impeccable timing. Have I done this one on my playthrough? Huh. I don't remember this one. Alright, well, we'll find it out and we'll figure it out together. So, I would assume... ha! One and done. One and done, son. Oh, chest. That's the other cool thing about the shrines, is that there's always a chest, so if you do the little extra bit of something or other, then... nice. Nice arrows. then you get a bonus thingy. And now... okay. When is good? Oh, we'd want it to pass through right about there, so now! No, wait. Now! Yes! Two and also done. Two and poo. Nope, got nothing. Okay. Off to a strong start this morning. And unlike most weekends, I'm going to not game... I'm going to not go over in the stream today because I have people coming over to play D&D, and actually Corwin is going to be showing up right around 12:30, but I doubt he's going to be on the stream because he said he's coming home from out of town and asked ahead of time if he could shower at my place because he didn't have a chance to, so he's going to be getting here at like 12:30 and taking a shower. Rather than, you know, coming on the stream and saying hi to people. I might be able to convince him to. He gets weird about streaming, I don't know. Yeah. Sand seals, that's a really cool mechanic. I love that. You sneak up on... it's essentially a... they call it a sand seal, but it looks a lot more like a walrus. That just dawned on me. It's a misnomer. Sand seal. But yeah, you sneak up on them, hitch a rope to them, and surf behind them on your shield. Which, shield surfing is also a super cool mechanic, but I don't do it because I like having shields, and they break super quickly when you're shield surfing. Pardon me. That's the other thing I'm going to work toward. I'm going to keep my ass hydrated while I'm streaming, because usually by the end of this, the end of the 2 hours, I sound like a pack-a-day smoker. I will tell Corwin you said hi, Nick. That's the other weird thing, is that I have to do a delay when streaming the console, because there's a... alt the tilt. Okay. There's an input lag between the game capture and the computer. So... you have to delay it. So normally when I would look over and go, oh, okay, everything's still going strong on the capture, I look over and it's delayed by like a second and a half and it's super weird. Alright. Wow, that was super easy. Something awesome! No! Ugh. That's something I need to do. That's something I will do on the stream. I'm gonna stop by Shakalaka and get myself some extra inventory space because I hate the limited inventory. I hate the limited inventory, I hate the breakable weapons. But aside from that, this game is flawless. That being said, they're, you know, good game mechanics, and they work as intended, so I can't really fault the developers for that, but I guess maybe some people like it. I don't get it. Do not get the appeal. Okay. So, stop time there. That, and that's not gonna work because of that. Okay, I'm done. Got it. I wonder, is there anything metal around? No. Awesome. Well, we're like 10 minutes in and I'm already stumped. This is great. All right, so let's see. Because I don't think I can make it up to there. Oh, ahahaha. All right, let's see what I can do here. I need to sledgehammer. I wanna be sledgehammer. That's not gonna work. Oh, I can do it with a bomb. Let's see if this works. Nope, did not work. Okay. Here. Instead of that, we do not that. That. And then. That's a dude, where's my car reference? Ooh boy. Digging into the back catalog there. Alright, so then this, that detonate, and then I guess that's the wrong direction. Up we get, please. Damn it. What if I just jump on one end? Come on. Maybe I'll do that on the stream too. It'd be really nice to upgrade my... Oh, that's not working at all either. Crap! Oh, I wonder if that first chest was metal. There we go. That's a thought. We're getting this. Yeah. Okay. You are mine now. You are mine to toy with. That is a Willow reference. If anyone watching has not seen Willow, you have homework to do. It is a classic. George Lucas, actually. Before? Before he did Star Wars? Or Learn? No. Oh, that's gonna bug me now. Anyway, it's a George Lucas production, and Warwick Davis is in there as the titular Willow. Val Kilmer, of all people, plays the Swordmaster Mad Mardigan, which is he's very entertaining in that. And yeah, it's just an all-around great film. Very fantasy-oriented, swords and sorcery sort of thing. Okay, that is not the answer. Oh. Ooh, boy. Yep, I am a genius. All right. Let's see. I'm on the edge here. Don't push me, because I'm close to the edge. I'm trying not to lose my head. Alright, come on. Up we get, and... Ah! No, the other way! Ah. So close. But yet, so far. Okay. Alright, there we go. Okay. Now... have to drop, turn. No, why does it? Oh, because of physics. I'm an idiot. Oh, maybe I can get enough height if I do it this way. go. Nice chest you got there. Be a shame if something happened to it. It was a boob joke that turned into a threatening mafia joke. What is my life, man? Alright, yes! Oh, that's awesome. How many of those do I have, I wonder? One. Cool. Yeah. There's that. Okay, so now, where'd my chest go? Because now you can use those to upgrade your slate powers. Shit, I need to do the thing first. Most notably, you can eventually use time stop on enemies, and that is an absolute game changer. Okay. Nope. Oh, I'm too slow. Oh. Well, okay then. Boom jams. Thank you. Lovely hat. You look like Raiden. There are times I wish I could wear a hat like that, but I would just seem racist if I did, I think. Come on. That's the other problem, is the loading screens. I mean, again, can't fault it, because the console weighs less than a pound, I think. So the fact that it has the processing power that it does is staggering. Maybe I will do that. Maybe I'll go... Yeah, I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna go on an adventure. I'm gonna go up to... What was that place called? Hatno Village. No, that's the account. Oh, no, not that one. Oh, where are you? Boo, boo, boo. Kakariko. There's Hatno. Okay. Girls. Yeesh. Someone's at the door, I think. Or it's possibly nothing at all. Because those are the things that my dogs bark at. Either someone at the door or literally nothing. Maybe I'll get a cool horse too. There's all this, like, this game is so expansive and there's all this extra stuff to do that it's really easy. Like, it's difficult recording episodes of this because you'll be like running toward an objective and then you'll see 17 different things along the way that are interesting and you want to play with. Like, this is a game simultaneously designed for people with ADD and those people's the bane of their existence all at the same time. So let's see, where is the lab? The lab is up there, but more important, where is the furnace? Because since I've done this already, I know ahead of time that I'm gonna go all the way up there, and then person there is going to tell me to come all the way back down to get this flame over here. So, I'm gonna, for your sake, I'm going to save a bunch of time and do this quicker. Well, maybe not quicker, but more efficiently, if nothing else. Do I have anything flammable? You'll work, I think. Torch would be better, but I think the closest place to get a torch is up on the mountain. So, we're just doing this. And yeah, this is a super fun mechanic as well. Well, maybe not super fun, but pretty fun. Oh, I remember how I do this. I think. But yeah, you have to do this here and at the ancient tech lab up elsewhere. Cut down tree. Yeah. Boom. There we go. Can I? I cannot. Cool. That was a worthwhile use of everyone's time. Well done, Adam. Alright, so here we go. I'm gonna have to go down and around. I feel like there was a way to do that. I feel like I've done that in the past. Meh. Or no, I did. Yeah. I did exactly that same thing when I was playing on my personal playthrough, so yay for memory. Or lack thereof. Set myself on fire. It's fine. This link is on fire. So is your field! Oh. Whoops. You see that guy who ran by and set your field on fire? That was crazy. Definitely wasn't me. Bye. But yeah, that's the kind of stuff I'm talking about where I didn't set that guy's field on fire in my playthrough. And so I didn't realize you could, but this game is very... I believe the way I've heard it put is this is a game that says yes. Like to anything the player asks, it's just like yes, you can do that. So it encourages creative thinking, and it's just I could just expound for days about how much I love this game. I mean, as evidenced by the fact that I've played through the entire thing on my own, and like for these streams, you know, it's not that big a draw for the channel, and it's mostly just because I kind of enjoy streaming, and so I could pick pretty much anything to play, and yeah, I've probably hit 100 hours on this game by now. Between the two playthroughs, but I've played it that long and still choose to play it on the stream. I need the tree branch. Gimme. Can I set this on fire? Ha! Sorry, lady. What a nice breeze. Wait, you just complained about the breeze. Okay. It doesn't carry that tang of salt on it, though. Oops, I forgot we just met. I was remembering about my hometown of Lurling Village by the sea. The view and the air are different here in Hadano Village, but this is where my wonderful husband calls home. I count myself lucky to be able to live and work alongside such a wonderful, loving man. Oh, did I ask for your life story? Good God. It's a small fishing community far to the south. I live there. No wonder either of them survived the trip. Sure. Why not? And just need something made of wood. And the tree branch. Oh, yeah, that was genius. Why did you think that would work? I have nothing! Nope, no tree branch. Sweet treats and sweet meats. Ooh, side quest. Hey, you! Oh, it's a girl.
Hey, you!
Yes?
What do you want?
Oh! Don't act so clueless.
He turned her into a Muppet.
Don't act so clueless. Although, fine.
You seem harmless enough. Forgive me, I've just been on the edge with all these monsters running around. They come up from Hatton O Beach to steal my sheep. someone doesn't do something soon, I won't have any left. Ah, the sheep rustlers. Yes, of course. Alright, well, give me a torch. Give me a torch, and I'll take care of your sheep. I carry a torch for your sheep. Damn it. Alright, well. How far am I from the fucking lab? Because I know there's a torch up next to the lab. But I didn't want to go that far, just to turn around and go back. Because reasons. Oh, that is a ways. That sucks. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Trying to think of any random stories that have happened recently. Started taking notes on them so that I could talk about them on the stream, and of course I left my notes at the office, so I don't know what story. Oh! I had an interesting dream. Well, and by interesting I mean kind of very fucked up. So, it was me and my family and my grandpa who died, in a parking lot somewhere. And we're walking along and, my cat, Schrodinger, runs up and for some reason he's outside, which, you know, we don't do that because he would run off because he's a cat. So he's out there with us, and he runs literally underfoot, and my grandpa steps on his tail by accident. And rather than, you know, the cat freaking out or this, that, the other, the tail falls off. And that was super weird. And so I comfort the cat, and it's just like, it's okay, you're all right, because it was a clean break. Apparently, and it detached and was fine. So, you know, I comfort the cat. Cat's okay. Cat turns around, runs underfoot again. And this time, he doesn't get stepped on, but somehow, like, it was either a shovel or a separate catapult. You know how dreams are sometimes. That catapult. That was unintentional. Somehow, my grandpa launches the cat backwards over his shoulder. And the cat lands, and the cat is dead after landing. And it was really traumatic. Like, even in the dream, I'm just like, I was really super sad. And, so, my brother, being the caring person that he is, he gathers up the remains and, you know, goes to take care of them so that I wouldn't have to go through that. And, so I'm mourning, and, well, my wife is there and super freaking out because, you know, she, absolutely, like, you know, I love the animals, but it's possible that she loves them more. And so, you know, we're sad and freaking out, and then I go, wait, he might be okay. And I go, and the smushed cat has transformed into a pile of green goo, which was weird. And so I pick him up, and it's just like, is he really okay? And then it, like, the pile of goo starts, it grows like frog legs and, like, opens eyes and looks at me. And he was fine, and I was relieved by that. But, you know, it's weird. What? Linky? Is it really you? Snappity snap.
No, no, no. Now is not the time for this. The gun's so suddenly working again. Now Linky has arrived. Say, Linky, did you, by any chance, happen to light the furnace with a blue flame?
That's true, but
if you figured out how to do that without being told, you must have come out of the slumber of restoration in good shape.
Well, yeah, I had abs for days.
Oh, yes, I forgot to introduce myself. I am the Had No Ancient Pura! Snappity snap! Ah, yes. It seems I spilled all the beans all by myself about the role of the true director of this place. My apologies, Linky. It seems you have yet to fully grasp the specifics of the situation at hand. I'll just speak bluntly, how about... You were instructed by Impa to come here to have your Sheikah Slate repaired, correct?
Precisely.
Called it!
We'll get to that, but soon we have some questions. Anyway, Linky, do you remember... Oh my god. Time and slumber of restoration. You haven't changed a drink in 100 years, but something must have happened in all that time. Well, no matter. Just happy to stay in one place, Linky. Oh, what's with that look? You still remember me, right? I don't remember. Well, I'm so shocked, I don't know if I'll ever be able to recover from this. Even though 100 years ago, I took you to the Shrine of Resurrection after Calamity Dan. Even though I was the one who put you initially into the Shrine, despite all that, you still don't remember me. Hmm? For 100 years, the subject is lost on memory. Noted. Oh, sorry. I have a bad habit of taking ropes rather blood. Oh my god, I can't speak today. It's a charming quirk, isn't it? Anywho, do you have any more questions? No. No, I don't. How very rude. Yeah. Or perhaps not rude at all. I suppose that actually is a rather logical conclusion to jump to. The truth is, I look this way because of a failed experiment. Well, I say failed, but in some ways it was a success. I documented in full the affair in my diary upstairs. But the whole thing is embarrassing, so I insist you refrain from reading it. Anyway, enough about that. Back to the topic at hand. Well, then let's go ahead and restore those Sheik straight runes for you. Give me a nice snap. Nah. Oh, really? Post-slumber, somebody has a tendency to give uncomfortable responses to questions. Well, if you change your mind, you know where to find me. Oh, wait, oh! You bitch. I mean... I was gonna try to... Yeah, I try not to swear on the streams quite so much. Whatever. Snap! Give me things. Okay, then. Guidance stone lock removed. Now, let's do this thing. Leroy Apura! Hi, Ronan. How you doing? Sheikah Slate authenticated. Oh my god, the cutscenes. Drippy droppy, drippy droppy. And I've been told that the text on these is supposed to change, but it keeps being the same thing for me, at least. It says, master using it and you can have this. Which is from the first game. Rune has been added. Sweet. Yep, so now we've got another long quest line. And an even longer quest line after that. Which, I'm actually... I probably won't go for that one, but I will go for the Recovering the Memories quat line. Yes, it's the combination of quest line and plot line, just for anybody, in case anybody is wondering. And it's done. So, is it all fixed up now? Yes, let's see. Which one is it? Yeah. Camera, Hyrule Compendium, album. Yep, looks good.
So I know this is sudden, but hear me out. Take a picture of me with the camera. Oh, and don't forget to let me see.
Well, then, we'll do... Nope. Alright. So freaking cute, it's ridiculous. Boom jams! So there we have that. Nope. Get out. Erp. Eep up. Or Yes, talk. Come on! Hey, now, how's the picture taking going? Yes. Here you go. Tried for the upskirt, but it didn't work. That's terrible. She's a child.
My, who is this beautiful young creature?
It's me. Wasn't on purpose. Kind of lost it there. Oh, it's not just a pretty girl in these images. Yes, these are some old landscape photos stored in the album. I knew Princess Zelda made frequent use of the camera feature, but this... Hey, Linky, it dawns on me that you were Princess Zelda's appointed knight, which means there's a strong possibility that you accompanied her to all the places where these pictures were taken. Oh, right. The lost memory thing could prove troublesome. But don't lose hope. It just means that these pictures could be the missing piece to help restore your lost memories. If my hunch is correct, I suggest you check with Impa. She knows more about Princess Zelda than I, even I do. Yeah, just one more thing. Don't have to worry about ancient materials. Yeah, give them to her or the other guy, and they can... She upgrades my runes, and crazy guy up at the other place can make ancient armor and anti-guardian arrows and super cool stuff. Yeah. Power all the things up. I don't have enough cores to power up stations yet, which sucks because I badly want to do that. But I think I should have enough for the other two. Yes. All right, I'm gonna stop reading all of this. This is really going. All right, Sheik Sensor. Yep. Yes, I got 3 screws for you, little, It's terrible, absolutely terrible. Okay then, Guiding Stone, blah, blah, blah. The whole reading dialogue thing is actually kind of interesting, because it brings back bad memories, honestly. Oh wait, this is different. Oh, no, never mind. Same message, got excited for a second. The reading aloud thing actually brings back some memories. Because back, it was like 6th grade, I think, I always got terribly nervous whenever I had to read aloud in class. So, whenever I got called on to do that, I would stutter horribly because I was freaking out, and like, I never stuttered when I was talking normally, and I read, you know, at a much higher, grade level than what I was at, and, but in 6th grade, I actually, like, my teacher got so concerned that she called in, like, one of the special needs tutors, or, like, one of the teachers from there, and, you know, pulled me out into the hallway and is just like, hey, you know, read this thing for a little while. And I'm just like, can I read my book instead? And I pull out this, you know, this tome that's this thick fantasy book that I had from my dad. And she's just like, yeah, sure. And so I plop down and I start reading for like 10 minutes. And I'm like, I didn't put together what was going on. I was just loving the hell out of the fact that I could just sit there and read instead of being in class. But then... like about 5 or 10 minutes into me just sitting out there reading, and she just turns to me and goes, you don't have any trouble reading, do you? I'm just like, no, of course not. Why, what? And she's just like, nothing, never mind, go back to class. And like was super embarrassed about the whole thing. But still to that day, especially in front of the internet, apparently I still have reading issues, or nervousness issues, I should say. Do you have any other runes you'd like to? Yep. But I don't have enough cores, so we're not doing that yet. But eventually that shall happen. What do I want to do now? I'm gonna do the sheep rustlers. Name is... I'm gonna track down Russell Crow, Russell Brand, and, I don't know anybody else named Russell. It's Russell Hammond from, What's that from? Ah, damn it. Almost Famous? Is that the guy's name from Almost Famous? Yeah, I think that's right. I've decided that's right. Let's do this. Go. Whoop, almost missed the ledge there. Oh, ooh. That's a blue moblin. That's gonna be... I should have prayed a thing so that I could get another heart. Fuck that noise. Screw that noise. We're gonna do this instead. And sneaky. Oof, this is gonna be a challenge. Boom. Yeah. That's the other thing. I will be compulsively saving because obvious reasons. I've gotten good at this game, but there's a limit as to how good you can be with low-level equipment. And I decidedly have low-level equipment, and I've been spotted. Crap. Okay. Nope, stop sneaking. Alright. Nit. That was the wrong direction. Oh, and they all have spears. I hate spears. Ow. Stop sneaking. Don't poop. Well, that went well. Okay, then. Alright, well, that happened. I feel like I should do a shot or something every time that I die. Link indeed is a hoarder, Drew, I agree. Got tons of things, but not good things quite yet. And there are no explosives. There's no easy mode, it would seem, on this group. Okay. Shite. Oh, too many cooks. Boom. I'm taking the coward's approach. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, why are you so durable? Damn it. Okay. So we're gonna not do that quest right now and circle back to it later. We're gonna go do another shrine. Shrines are good. Shrines don't kill me, at least not as often as this. Oh, sorry about that. Must stay conscious. I'm gonna do this one, because I definitely didn't do this one in my personal game. Oh, yeah. I was about to say something, but I lost it. Damn it. Dang it, Bobby. Oh, I forgot to mention that all the live streams that I do, all proceeds go to charity. The current charity that I am focused on at the moment is charitywater.org. They're a group that helps to supply clean drinking water to developing nations. And the cool thing about them is that 100% of their administrative costs are all privately funded, so anything that gets donated goes directly to... Oh, poop. Okay. Goes directly to the cause of getting water to people, and that is cool. Try to shock the shit out of this guy. If I can win, that'd be cool. I doubt it, but we're gonna try. Ugh, okay. And the pressure's on. Nope. Ooh, nope! Shit. Ah, okay. That's fine. Different try. Gonna... Because I think I'm two shrines short, and then I'm gonna go pray, I'll get two more hearts, then we'll do some other things. It'll be fine. It'll be absolutely fine. Yeah. We'll just pretend that didn't happen. It's not like it'll be recorded on the internet forever. That's nope. Just doing this. Everything's fine. This is fine. Oh, so many loading screens. Oh, in case anybody missed it, this is important news for the entire internet to become aware of. And I would appreciate it if you... Muojim Shrine. I appreciate if you wait until after my stream is over to go act on this, but I would understand if you didn't. So yesterday, Adult Swim, like Cartoon Network Adult Swim, their April Fool's joke was not a joke at all. It was They aired the season premiere of, Rick and Morty. And so that is a thing that happened. They had it on a loop for, I think, 24 hours. And it was really, really good. And it is currently, like, it hasn't been taken down yet. It's currently up on YouTube. It's split into, like, 4 or 5 parts so that it gets around copyright things and doesn't get taken down. But, yeah, it is really good and keeps really well with the tone of the show. And very, very funny. And, I enjoyed the shit out of it. Nope, screw you. I need more small weapons that I can use a shield with. Woo, shit. Nope. Oh, come on. No. Bite. Wow, this fucker is durable. Shit. Everything's fine. Yeah, we're gonna do that. Get me some that going on. And you know what? We'll go for that as well. Because my gear is not up to snuff right now. Oh, crap. Okay. No more shields for me. Which sucks because he does that. Nope. He's going to do that thing. Nope. Shit. I'm going to run out of freaking weapons before I beat this guy. This is rough. Shit. That was a problem. And the reason I'm being all willy-nilly with my food is that I actually, in prep for the stream, I cooked up so many things that I learned that you can, in fact, overload your inventory with food items. Damn it. Do it again. Come on. Shit. Protect me, pillar. Oh, come on. Yeah, that's... Yeah. No more tests of strength. I need better weapons. This is fine. Give me puzzles. I like puzzles. And the puzzle things, like from the puzzle shrines, I can actually get myself some better equipment. So maybe I won't die quite so horribly over and over and over and over again. But yeah, it is what it is. Because, yeah, if you came here for expert gameplay, then I am sorry to disappoint, but you... Nope. Definitely not. Yeah. You're in shrine. You're in shrine. Yeah. Or it's just you're in shrine. All right. Down to the peepee shrine. Let's do this. Blah, 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 blah. Oh, weighty decision. Oh, okay, cool. See this? Physics. I know physics. I can do this. Whee! This is shit that I can absolutely do. Wait, no. Wait, stop that. Eh. Oh no. Why am I using my torch? Oh, I jumped out of the way of that. Fuck you. Yep, this whole not swearing thing is going really well for me, guys. At least you're actually doable. Whoop. Nope. Breakable inventory. Boom jams. That is neat. See, now that is what I could use against that other shrine. Need to get more of that going on. Are you metal? Cool. Okay. Wait. Give me you. Boom. Fantabulous. I can work with that. That's pretty neat. Yeah, I love this game. Like the little puzzles and the even littler, like the shrines have all the little puzzles in them, and then like the Koroks are the tiny itty bitty mini puzzles, mostly just involving lifting up every freaking rock in Hyrule to see what you can find and to see if you can find any Koroks. But, you know, it is what it is. But some of them are actually puzzles. And some of them are like Superman 64, where you have to glide through rings, but not like Superman 64 in that you want to kill everyone you've ever met after trying it once. Because good God, just good God, it's bad, guys. If anybody's ever played Superman 64, I'm sorry. And yeah. A friend of mine brought up something interesting not too long ago. He apparently, like, it's one of those things where how other people's brains work is interesting to me, and how, like, the spark of inspiration and where, you know, how stuff pops into your head. It's like, there's one time that Corwin was talking about how, you know, scared of, like, fear about staring into the sun for 3 seconds and then transforming into a Benihana chef. Where does that come from? Where do you get Benihana chef from? I mean, anything at all. It's weird. One of my buddies is just like, you got to think about, like, the history of humanity and this, that, the other. And I was expecting something like really heavy coming from him. And he follows it up with, he's just like, you know, when was the first time somebody, like, maple syrup, you know, where did somebody get the idea to go, you know, oh, this sticky stuff that comes out of a tree, we're gonna pound a tap into the bark of this tree and then drink this shit. It's just like, first off, I mean, that's actually an interesting thought experiment, but where does that come from? Like, it's impressive sometimes. But then, of course, we theorized for, you know, a little while. Go, Mank. Gonna go to Go Mank Shrine. You know, I would imagine that it was a lumberjack. And you guys feel free to discuss in the chat if you would, if you want to weigh in on your theories, but I would imagine that it was a lumberjack who just happened to... Metal doors, open the way. Either he was in his jacking fervor while cutting down a tree, he happened to, like, you know, recoil in such a way that a bit of sap flew into his mouth, and he goes, that could go well on pancakes, because I'm assuming pancakes were invented before syrup. That was awesome. But yeah, I would imagine it is either either that or just a crazy person collecting trees. but I don't know. I feel like I should look that up at some point, but I'm not going to. Yeah, you'll do. That worked well. Nope, 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 nope. Problems. We've got problems. I'm not using that sword, because that's useful to me. Sweet. All right. And get some of this anti-guardian stuff. And that'll work well. Okay, that's where I came in. Good job, me. Oh! Completely lost, and then there's a very obvious second set of doors. No. Oh, God. Physics. Sneak on right through there. What you got? What you got for me? Sweet. I believe that all of my... I hope my bows are all better than that. Yes, they are. Cool. So that happened. Oh. Oh. I got it. I got it. No. Oh, God. That was almost English. There you go. Stay. Goodbye. There we are. Now, coming with me, door. Alright, so. I'm gonna go. Which one of these had the stairs on it? Yeah. The one that's not particularly words. Convenient. Convenient. Yeah. Oh, that happens more often than I'd care to admit. But I choose to blame it on lack of sleep and not early onset of Alzheimer's or dementia. I'm still pretty early for like that. I'd even be early for early onset, so I think I'm fine. Right, guys? Great. You're made of metal, so you come here. Thank you. Be better than that bow. I'll do. Yeah, that's something I haven't done yet in the in-between times of episodes. Oh, crap. Go back down there. Heh. Alright. I've not farmed for rupees nearly as much as I should. But part of that is that I haven't sold any of my stones and stuff, which those are worth a pretty penny, which would be useless because they use rupees here, but whatever. It's fine. Explosion of blue matchsticks. It burns the skin. But yeah, that, I forgot what I was talking about. Awesome. Definitely not losing my mind. Oh, rupees. Yeah, that's... Because... Also, I've got things that I would like to buy eventually. Like, and there's a side quest where you can buy a house, which is... awesome. Like the implication, like I think it's in Hatno Village. The implication is that it was your house 100 years ago, because they say, oh, this was abandoned 100 years ago. It's just like, really? That's good time. Like that's very fitting timing. And they're getting ready to demolish it, but you can then go, no, I want to buy it, and I want to say it's like 10 grand or something. So that's kind of crazy. Early settlers in the U.S., Northeast, and Canada learned about sugar maples from Native Americans. Oh, that makes sense. Various legends exist to explain the initial discovery. Duh. I should have thought of that. I didn't. All right, we're going to Yanaga Shrine. Yanaga! That sounded bad. Yeah, lightning strikes. Lightning has a tendency to strike anything metallic. I mean Naga, like the giant snake monster in D&D, and various other things. Shatter the heavens. Oh, heavens. Ooh, neat. Okay. We do this one, and then we do this one, and we do that, and let's see if we can get back on. Oh, I should roll it into place first. That makes sense. Kick you, get in there. There we go. That's neat. And then go to this one. Into the pipe. And the chief of a tribe threw a tomahawk at some tree sap, ran out, and his wife boiled venison in the liquid. Another version holds that Native Americans stumbled on sap running from a broken maple branch. Those are, yeah, this makes sense to me. All right, so now detonate and detonate. Yeah, that went well. 40 gallons of sap to make 1 gallon of maple syrup, because sap is about 98% water. Things I did not know. Oh, crap. Wait. How do? No, that wouldn't work. Oh, that would work. Okay. Wow, that's interesting and cool. I think, if I'm understanding this correctly. Also, learning about maple syrup is more interesting than I was expecting. All right. It's that sort of academic curiosity that I rarely take the time to indulge. Sweet. Now I need to ride it up. Now we do this thing. Set that bomb down on my head. You go there. And then you go there. Then and then we do thing, and we do that thing, and then we do this thing. Hope that it gets me high enough. Whoa! Yeah, I'd say that did it. Okay. Neat. Now I just need to... Oop. Aha! There's the secret chest. It's like when girl stuffs her bra. It's secret chest. Oh boy, devolving into madness. Eightfold blade. I've heard you can only fold a blade. That's paper folding jokes. Not sure if you can count them as jokes. Ooh, that's the other thing. In addition to checking out the new Rick and Morty episode. Anybody who has your hashtag not sponsored, anybody who has Crunchyroll premium membership, season 2 of Attack on Titan, the first episode went up yesterday and is great. I love that freaking anime, and it is very, very good, and they're keeping, you know, the same quality you would come to expect from the first season carries through. I wonder where the nearest, praying thingy is. There's one in Kakariko. We're gonna go to Kakariko! Ah, it burns to be turned into blue spaghetti! I think of other interesting things that I could show you in the game. Because at this point, I'm just sitting around playing. Like I feel like I'm enjoying myself entirely too much for this to be a stream. Because I swear I could just play this game for days. I remember. That's I think the one thing that I actually miss from childhood is the amount of free time it allowed me. Like, I always felt more busy, but back in those days, I had time to just sit and play a game, like Fallout 3. I played Fallout 3, through from beginning to end multiple times.
Are you sorry to be- no. Sorry to bother you, but are you a fellow traveler? As for me, I just love art. In fact, I'm traveling the world in search of beautiful landscapes just between you and me.
There are no beautiful landscapes between you and me.
I hear there's a great fairy fountain somewhere near this village. I hear it's breathtakingly beautiful. Aesthetics aside, they also say the place can bestow people with some kind of mysterious power.
Flatulence.
I've been researching it for ages, and I finally have a lead. There's a place that is beyond suspicious.
So you hang a left, it's suspicious?
The problem is I can't find the fountain there.
Sigh.
Nothing beats the thrill of tracking down a perfect view. As a fellow traveler, do you understand the sentiment, right?
Sure.
Oh, I knew it. I just knew there was someone like me nearby who appreciates true beauty. Sadly, I can't pin down the exact location of the
great fairy fountain.
I haven't put it all together yet, but there's a suspicious place I have my eye on. In fact, I was going to head there now. Would you like to come along?
Sure.
Great answer. Just what I was expecting from a fellow beauty connoisseur like you. Alright then, follow me.
This is not suspicious at all. This guy's not going to lead me into a back alley and try to stab me. In either sense of the word. Other problem is that I think I remember where the fairy fountain is, but I think I have to wait on this guy to get there. So. It's like that moment where, like, you say bye to your friend, and then you realize that you parked in the same direction, and you've still got, like, several hundred yards to walk together, and, you just sort of, like, you try to lag behind the person and pretend that you're not going the same direction, but they know. They always know. There should be a name for that. You guys have a name for that. Hit me up. Okay, we good? It's been years since I visited the village. Probably noticed the people here all wear the same attire. I made the mistake of asking the same person the same thing multiple times. Oops! I was already a stranger to the village, but now I'm a suspicious roamer to them. But if it helps me track down a beautiful landscape, I don't care what people think of me. Oh, okay. Are we? Why did you stop then? Jerk. Because he reaches a point where he stops and says, oh, I can't make it any further because I'm old or whatever.
Oh, that's a special thing, and now it's gone. Poop.
Cutting the grass out of rage. Rage mowing. All right, are you? Okay, yeah, you're hands on the knees, hands on the knees.
So tired. Heels aren't easy for old fogies like me.
I feel you, brother. That's
sorry, but I don't think I can go on, pant.
Well, you're wearing like culottes, so I mean, I think you're fine. That's
the great fairy fountain should be along the path that leads past the shrine. Pant. That's where what I've been told, anyway. Yeah, I'm completely out of breath.
Then how are you talking? You are a lying sack of poop, and
that always happens right about here. Pant. I think I'd better rest for a bit. You go on ahead. And hey, if you find it, don't forget to get a picture.
Yeah, I believe it is down and to the left. Back and to the left. What are you? No. Now we're going to get a higher vantage point. And I was going to pray at that shrine to get more hearts, but that's clearly not happening now. There. Where? Darn it. It's going to bug me. He actually told me where it was, and I just wasn't paying attention. Because I was making my pants jokes. And, yeah. So, I'm an idiot. What? Is that you? Big orange things? This isn't Dark Souls. It's a little Dark Souls. Tiny bit Dark Souls. Oh, I don't have enough money. Okay, well, we're gonna take a picture, if nothing else. Because you pay the fairy to come out. Boom. Got the pictures. Oh, must be no one at the door. The dog is barking.
Everyone be very quiet. I'm sneaking up on a fairy. Yes.
Good. That's one in my personal game. Never caught a fairy because I was never patient enough to actually sneak up on them. But apparently if you have them in your inventory, they behave like in other Zelda games and will come out and revive you. And if you die in combat, the fairy will come out and revive you if it is just in your inventory. Ooh. Yep, focus is definitely an issue for me in this game. I'm just like, ooh, cool things! Ooh, other cool things! Like that, pro tip from the basket, that silent princess, it makes no mention in its description. Hello, puppy. Makes no mention in its description as to what... Good girl. Sorry, guys. Puppy. But yeah, it makes no mention in its description. Okay, come on up. Come on, girly. Here. Sorry, guys. Hang on. Come on. Oh, good girl. Okay, watch the mic. Here we go. Turn you away from the mic so that I can keep seeing. There we go. There's a good girl. Okay. But yeah, the Silent Princess, it makes no mention of where what it does when you cook with it, but if you cook just five of it, it gives you, like, it's a full restore and a bunch of extra stealth time, and it's really cool. My desire to view beautiful landscapes is stronger than anyone else's, even ever, I'm pretty sure. But my work can't handle this ground, blah, 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 blah. Don't I show you the picture? I took a picture. Okay, whatever, I'm doing the shrine. Then I'm gonna pray. Shrine, then pray. Eat, pray, love. Good girl. She is being surprisingly well-behaved right now. This is my dog, Whiskey, for anybody who doesn't know. She's half lab, half beagle, and she's adorable. Alright. Ooh, you okay? Hello, Nag's teaching. Okay. Great. Oh, it's a tutorial. Okay, cool, that's fine. Yes. There we go. If I had known that this was a tutorial shrine, I would not have gone into it, because obvious reasons. Yeah. Backflip. Do a barrel roll. Yes. Thank you. Eh? Ka-cha. Oh, whoops. Ka-cha. That's the backflip noise. All right. And now... Oh, yeah, the perfect block, which... You only ever use in one very specific circumstance, which is when you're fighting guardians. Whoops. All right, come on. Yeah. Dang it, Bobby. Use that. All right, come on. Yeah. No, come on. Yeah. There we are. Yeah. Are you dead yet? Build up your power, then release it to an... Yep. Catch your enemies in this motion. Yeah. Ka-cha! Oh. Ka-cha! Suck it. Alright. Sweet. Hello? Yeah, I know I did well. Come out. I'm Link. Have you met me? Alright. Oh, I can move back up closer to the screen now that the dog's gone. I'm gonna drop something useless, like this torch, and pick up the Guardian Sword. Sweet. Get a nice screw going. And let's see what's in here. Probably nothing good, because this is a tutorial shrine, which means that... Oh, sweet balls! Yeah, that was a thing that I just said. I mean, what? Alright. Cool. See, we're starting to build up some good equipment here. Gonna get better. Gonna be able to fight things. Gonna get myself some new hearts. Gonna be very good. Sweet, and another good shield. Nice. And there's an even better thing, probably. Probably gonna be another melee weapon. I'm probably gonna have to drop something else. But, we'll see. No, hey, cool. And I think you can also use stones for, like, building armor at various places, but I haven't found any of those yet. Like I said, I didn't speedrun my personal game, but I definitely skipped over a bunch of things. Like, I did exactly enough shrines to get enough parts to get the Master Sword. Which, definitely doing that in this game. Because, I mean, it's not exactly game-breaking, but it is more broken than not having it, to be sure. Because it's a, you know, a 30 attack weapon that never breaks. It just runs out of power if you're using it against non-Ganon, like, non-Calamity things. And then I think it's like 10 minutes or something where you can't use it. But then when you're fighting Calamity things, it starts glowing and becomes a 60 attack thing. Alright, you ready to look at my stupid picture yet? No. Jerk. Okay. Praying time. Ah, this goddess is getting ready to tuck into a nice lobster dinner. Conquer the shrine. Yep. Heart container, please. 2. I will say, I wish that this went faster as well. Like, I'm nitpicking the bejesus out of this game because there are so many good things, and it's so well designed and so intuitive, and there's just brilliantness all over the place. Thank you. Cool. Actually getting some power going. Yes, the power. Don't know where that came from. I'm not sure if anybody saw that. I'm not inclined to give Arnold Schwarzenegger a ton of credit when it comes to, I mean, most things. Ha, Dahmer Shrine. Ha! Dahmer. Cannibalism. Hilarious. But essentially, somebody was trolling and said something about the Special Olympics and, like, you know, very disrespectful, really offensive, and Arnold Schwarzenegger, of all people, called him out and was just savage, and he's just like, these people are doing something amazing and overcome, like, and they're, you know, they're being useful. What the fuck are you doing, essentially? And it's just like, damn, Terminator, you done good there. I can't remember the exact wording, but you should look it up because it was pretty entertaining. Ah, there we go. Stupid office chair got stuck in the non-reclined position. which I don't know about you, but I don't trust people who don't recline in office chairs. It doesn't make sense to me. Because why would you be sitting up when you could be reclining? And that's the same thing as with the, ooh, excuse me, sorry about that, everybody. Like the little knob on the bottom that sets the, like, the resistance for reclining. First thing I do when I sit in any chair is loosen that to its extreme, loose end so that I literally, like, I just have to do nothing at all to just be back here. Sweet, rupees. Whoa! Okay, good. Just like, I can't see the floor! What am I doing? Okay. Here. Yeah. And, see, this is what I'm saying about it's like, the puzzles are different, and they are clever and intuitive, and freaking love them. Freaking love this game. Well, that was not quite in the right place. How about there? It's fine. And we just hit one right about. Oh, go quickly! Gently! Yes! God, I love this game. Oh, I already got the extra chest. Never mind. Yeah, I'm good. I'm just like, where's the thing? You just did it. Literally just did it. Can't keep my brain on straight. Hey. You gonna explode like those other people? Yeah. Neat. Boom. Motherfucking James. Cool. What else I could do? That's what I'll do. That shall be my next quest. I'm going to venture out into the very frightening Central Hyrule region to see if I can gather some of those ancient cores. Because I need two more, then I can upgrade my stasis, and that would be cool. So where am I? Where am I at? Actually, before I do that, I'm going to save because I'm going to die in this endeavor, and that's okay because I'm okay with me as a person. Okay, Central Hyrule. Oh, sorry about that, guys. It's a little bit chilly down in the basement today. But we'll go for this one, and if I manage to do this, then I will try to do... There's a shrine quest, something about three brothers, something like that. Where there are these three mini-bosses, and you have to kill each of them to get one of the glowing orange thingies, and then that reveals a shrine to you. So, let's see if I can do that. And... Yep! Come on. Damn it. Oh, thank you, fairy. And that is why it is worth it to have a fairy in your inventory. Oh, poop. That just broke right away. Alright, because I know that this is possible. I just gotta get the timing right. Nope. Shit. That's the wrong menu, even. Okay, come on. Nope, get out your shield! What are you doing? Damn it! Alright, this might be a mistake. Oh, come on! hoop. Yep. All right. So that was not a good move on my part. Man, the range on this sucker. Yeah, if you use the properly timed shield block thing, then it reflects the beam right back at them, and they die in one hit, and that's pretty neat. But I didn't do that. I'm gonna blame the input lag from the capture card. Yeah, that sounds good to me. All right, let's go fight those dudes. Where are those dudes? I'm so old. Where were those? They were near a different shrine. No, it's not there. There? No, it's not there. Come on, where are you? I tried ducking and weaving, Corwin. I tried. Wait, if you're... I thought you were driving. Well, oh, he's here apparently. Okay, he could come say hi if he wanted to. Where the balls is that? I knew. Darn it! This is gonna bug me. There's like three skeleton looking things. Maybe it's on the east side. East side? Not in the desert. Ah. This is gonna bug me. Yep. You know what? I'm not too proud. I'm gonna pull up a map quick and look for it. Pay no attention to this. There it is. Okay. Because, yeah, for the sake of you guys, not going to just randomly. See, there's the things. Okay. So, it's right about there. So, what's the closest fast travel? It is right about there. To the urine shrine! Corwin's in my bathroom. Interesting, if nothing else. All right. I get to go straight from doing this to DMing for D&D. So, not like there's going to be any mental taxation issues going on. We're going to mark the Mapipu. Or that one. There. Alright. So, hopefully I can actually accomplish something here. Because that would be nice, as opposed to the many, many failures that have gone on during this stream so far. I don't want to fight those people. Or maybe I should. They might have good gear. They have exploding barrels. That's neat. Gonna go ahead and... What? Damn it. Oh, maybe because it's raining. Oh, you dick. Still killed you. I don't have a shield. That sucks. Nope. All right, off to a great start. Wow. Nope. Okay. We're gonna... yes. That instead. Come on, come on, come on. Yep. Come on, get up. There we go. Okay. Remembering how to play the game. There are times that I have to focus on playing the game as opposed to trying to be interesting for you guys, because shit's hard sometimes. I mean, I know that I am not a particularly skilled gamer, but, you know, it's something. Damn it. Oh, come on. Okay, it's fine. It's fine. No, actually lock on a person. You stupid elf boy. Oh, everything's fine. Everything's fine. Oh, shit. I mean, poop. Breaking everything. This is definitely worth my time. Worth my time and equipment to do this. That is for darn sure. Damn it. Alright. That's true. I would like some of some paprikash. That's a good plot, and that's a good call. I would assume that means that there is some, and obviously it's not here, and that's upsetting. Alright. Cool. Is that everybody? I hope that was everybody. Wow, lots of arrows they missed me with, so that's something. New shield, that's good. Knight's broadsword, that's good. That is my endless quest in this game, is to find light weapons, because I am a, in every possible form, I am a sword and board fighter, and so I like having a small sword and a shield to play with. And when you have the large weapons, you can't use your shield, and it becomes very difficult. Also, again, much like reading in front of people, I get nervous super easy, so normally I'm better at this game, I swear. I know that sounds like a cop-out, but shut up. Have you considered shut up? That's something that you could do. No. Oh, this one's almost broken, so we'll drop that one to get this new win. Nifty sauce. Screw you, barrel. You're going down there. So am I. All right. I love that. That mechanic where it's just like you can free fall. Excuse me. In order to maintain your stamina. And then just immediately, like, as long as you hit the glide button right before you hit the earth, you're perfectly fine. And I'll take a moment for anybody who joined late to reiterate that all my streams are for charity. Today's charity is charitywater.org, which is a nonprofit that supplies clean drinking water to developing countries. And their administrative costs are 100% privately funded, which means that any money that gets donated goes straight to the cause, which is awesome. Some charities, it feels good to give to them, but then you realize that something like 80% goes to overhead, and that kind of sucks. Just by watching, you are supporting that charity, so that's pretty neat. If you want to support them directly, there is a link up in the upper right corner of the video that you can click on, and it will take you through donating to them. Which I recommend doing, because I think it is a worthwhile cause. Because with all of, you know, I know there are a ton of charities out there, but when it comes down to it, you know, you can't, you cannot live without water. And, yeah. I guess that's all I have to say about that. What weapon do I have? You'll do.
Alright, everybody be very quiet. We're gonna sneak up on this guy, and then we're gonna stab him a bunch. And hopefully we won't die too quickly, or horribly.
Come on. I tried fighting this guy on one of the episodes that I don't think has aired yet, but... Hello? Oh, I couldn't stand up to strike him because I was under his bulk, as it were. Oh, he's got a thing on his leg! No! Oh, boy. Okay. So, my normal strategy here. Run under his ass, make him do that, and then slash him a bunch. And occasionally, it works well. Oh no, run, 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 run! Okay, getting greedy there, that's fine. You can also... Oh no, you can also miss him, and then get killed. That's also an option. Oh, come on! Yeah, there we go. And that puts him down for a bit. Running time! Okay. Perfectly fine, perfectly fine. Oh, come on, up your nose with a rubber hose! There we go. Pulling out the Cotter insults, there we go. Alright, die, 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 please die, please die, please die. Yes! I am victorious! Thank you for all of you that believed in me. And, anybody who didn't, that's fine. I mean, that's perfectly reasonable assumption, given how I've been playing today. Blue Shell Escargot. Interesting. Sweet. I don't remember getting a bunch of food from this guy the last time I fought him in my personal game. Dragon Bone Boko Spear. Hate spears, but whatever. Brittany, Pickle, all spears. Yeah, there is the middle thing. If all goes well, I'll be able to get this done before I have to end the stream today. But, again, given how today has gone so far, it may or may not go well in the least. But we do what we can, and really, the upper body strength on Link is just staggering at this point. Like, you seeing this? He's just like, nope, no effort, no big deal. Woo, big thing made of stone. In you get. That is powered up. And there's the thing that describes the challenge. And yeah. Alright, now that we've done that, we're gonna go ahead and save this quick. Oh, I can't remember. One of them has a bunch of little guys around him. And they make things difficult, to say the least. But I don't think it's this one, because I'm not seeing anybody. Oh yeah, I think this guy's the easiest one. Oh, it autosaved. Cool. All right. Sneaky, sneaky, cannot see me. Sneaky, sneaky, I am Link. Hero time, but I'm gonna sneak up on you and hit you while you sleep. Cause, yeah. There's a difference between being a coward and being smart. And I choose to believe that I am smart. S-M-R-T. Oh, poop. It's fine. It's fine. Yeah, it's a good thing he's the youngest one. Yep, can't catch me. Oh, I am under his ass. That's bad. Come on. Come on. Do a butt slam. Be like Mario. Do a butt slam. Damn. face. There we go. Why is your face? That is what I just said. Alright, good, good, good. Oh, get out of there! Alright. Oh no, out of stamina. Crap. Sorry, anybody wearing headphones. That was a little noisy. We're gonna go ahead and eat a little bit there. It's gonna be fine. Oh, stamina, please. There we go. Okay. Can't get to me, I'm the gingerbread man. Nope. Alright, secondary. That's good. That'll do. Bleh. Back at ya. Dang it. They also get wise. My tricks. Nope, nope, nope. Die, 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 die. Yes! Boom! That's another one. It's two down. This is going amazingly well. Nice palm fruit. And this Boko Bat, which is not a quick enough weapon to use in this situation, but whatever. And we got another ball. Yeah. There's the thing that I need to go up to, not the other one. Yeah. And again, I've got this weird delay that I have to do to make the thing work, and it's throwing me off anytime I look over at the screen. But whatever, it's fine. Everything's fine. I don't have too many random thoughts to share with you guys today. Weird. Oh, no, leave me alone. Leave me alone, I have a ball. Oh, you dicks. It's downhill. Oh, you bone dicks. You boners. No! Oh, Jenna, oh. Okay, all right. Thank you, Mr. Tree. You were very helpful. Itch nose. Yeah, okay. So, progress. Progress is being made. Despite these jerks. Oh, no. They're all gonna laugh at you. All right. Back when Sandler was funny. I know. It's hard to believe. All right, so. It. That one. Now, right? Wait. Yeah, so this way? I think it's this way. I also lose all sense of direction when I'm playing this game. But that's fine. It's fine. Yeah, this is the big guy, I think. The eldest kin. Because he's got backup guys who have shock arrows. And that sucks. So I'm actually going to go ahead and eat some stealth food. So that I can sneak up on them. Hopefully. Take them out of the equation. Because dodging the big guy is hard, but dodging electricity arrows at the same time is quite difficult. Water probably makes me noisier, doesn't it? Yes, it does. Okay, good. It's auto-saving. That's good. Can't hear me. Nothing going on back here. Pacha! You're dead, son. You're dead. Your family. Dead. Your chickens. Dead. I'm gonna drop something so I can pick up that rod. Dead. Yeah, this one, because it's a less good version of that one. All right. Ooh, rice. Things that I choose to get excited about in this game. Yeah, okay, better than nothing. All right, so I know there are more guys around. It's called working smart, not hard. And certainly not working fast, but, you know. Shit happens. I mean, poop happens.
Swearing less?
Yeah. It's working out super well so far. Alright, where... Wait. There's gotta be more than just the one dude. Oh, there's one up on the thing there. So I'm probably safe going a little quicker. Do I sneak up on him or do I arrow him from afar? Oh, there's a dude. He's all up and about too. That did not go well. That was not great. I'm hiding behind this tree. Hey, all right. Cool. Okay. Problem is, I think if I stealth strike this guy, it will wake up Big Man. And also, it's almost morning, so they're going to wake up anyway. And that's not great. It is not not a good time. Hi, Corwin.
Hey, Ed. What's going on?
I'm streaming.
What you playing?
Zelda. You were watching from the toilet.
Yeah, I guess I was. This doesn't look at all the way I thought it would. I thought this was going to be a significantly more violent, action-packed, and dark adventure.
We've played, like, 14 episodes of this on the show.
Oh, we have? Shit.
Yes, we have shit.
What a neat little album. Are you not wearing pants? Are you fighting pantsless?
No, they're tan pants.
That's exactly
they're
what
tense.
I would say. Pants. They're tense.
If you want to duck down a little more, you'll get into camera.
Oh, yeah. Sorry, everybody.
Hi.
I just took a shower, so I'm nice and moist, and I'm bringing up the moisture levels around Adam's head.
I no longer want you to be on camera. Oh, come on.
I'm sorry, that's just the moisture.
Somebody was on earlier, wanted me to tell you they said hi. It was Nick.
Nick? Yeah, that's my little brother.
Oh, okay.
He's a cool cat.
No, he's not. Oh, he's a person.
He is a person.
You're a liar. Whoa.
Hello, whiskey.
That was an interesting noise.
That's a dog.
Thanks, Corwin. Well identified.
Whoa, what's that cool looking sword you got there?
It's a sword. I don't know, man.
Okay, well, fight the big fat dude.
That's what I'm trying to do.
It's kind of a hate crime, but whatever. You do you, boo.
It's not a hate crime.
Is he a frog person?
No, he's
Why is he sleeping on a chest?
Oh, that's... come on! That's just cheating. Oh, nope. Get off the...
Okay, that was really funny, actually. The fact that you woke him up and immediately climbed on wood.
Well, it wasn't on purpose.
Sure it wasn't.
Yeah.
Like freshman year at college.
Oh, man, he is fast.
He's pretty fast.
Damn it. Oh, come on.
I love how his eye looks.
Nope. Nope, nope, nope. Mistakes. Mistakes were made.
Mistakes were made.
All right, we're going to run under his... No!
Ooh,
oh, well, that was useful to me, but... Remember how I said it sucks to have to dodge electricity stuff while fighting the big guy? That's what I'm talking about. I'm gonna eat more food. There's a chat over there. Your brother says what up.
What it be, Nickadoo? You look pretty fly for having an N.
Damn it!
I got nothing, dude. I'm sorry.
Nope, this is not going well.
The other ones went really smoothly, and this is not going well. What? Get out of here, you jerk.
Oh no.
You can't help but watch this thing and feel like it's got the voice of, like, the little hen that baked the bread.
What?
You know that child hen thing about the chicken who's like... I sowed the wheat, I cut the wheat, I made the bread, and now all y'all want some of my bread.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Yeah, it's all about, like, helping people do stuff and not...
Oh, no!
Oh, that didn't look good at all.
I got That was a tree trunk that came and killed me.
Maybe if you helped plant the seed and grow the tree.
I know, right? The darn, I would have gotten chicken bread, and that would have helped me.
Chicken bread helps everybody.
Yeah.
I feel like chicken bread is like the worst rapper. Yo, chicken bread up on stage!
Nope, the worst rapper is an Australian guy that goes by R-A-E-D. Not sure how to pronounce that exactly, but that's his handle, and he is the worst. And the second worst is a guy named Stitches.
Oh, Stitches. You told me about Stitches.
I never listened to Stitches. We've got to do that at some point, because he's got his debut, like his breakout hit was called Brick in Your Face.
And Brick in Your Face?
Yes. It is all about selling cocaine, and it is glorious. And the video makes it even better.
Wow.
Because there's one, like, for some reason, Pinhead from Hellraiser is in the video. And
is he, like, just having a coffee? Is he just hanging out?
No, he has a brick of cocaine, and he is slowly breaking it open, like, tearing it open on the pins that are on his face.
Wow.
It is a trip.
Okay, I'm just going to say this right now on this show. I've never done nor intend to have any sort of interaction with cocaine. But if I did, I would cover my face with nails and bash my face into pounds of it, because that seems like the best way to do it.
That is the correct way to ingest cocaine, yes.
And given that this grand guy Stitches told me how to do it, I should really send him a thank you letter.
That is true. That's you owe him big.
Maybe I'll send him some bandages.
But yeah, he's got Brick in Your Face, and then...
Can you open the chest when he's...
Oh, no!
Like, can you just, like, open the chest and run away?
No, I need to magnet it out of the the dirt. Stop moving! Hit your crotch. Crotch. Run!
It's like you're trying to, like, trim his pubes and doing a really good job.
Not a great job.
Well, enough that it's doing damage to him.
Oh, no! Whoa!
Okay, in your defense, he just started breakdancing and no one knew he could do that.
I did not expect that. That was that was news to me, man. Oh boy.
Instead of throwing yourself at enemies over and over again.
Shut up, Battletip. You don't know me.
You don't know what I've been through.
You don't know my life. Okay.
I got a Jones soda yesterday,
yeah.
And I read the inside of the cap, and it said you should hide for a few days. So, I don't know how to handle that in a piece of information.
I think you need to hide for a few days. I think Mr. Jones knows some things.
Well, hey guys, just so you all know, I'm going to be hiding out here in Adam's basement.
That's not good hiding.
So if you need to get a hold of me in my new hiding spot, you hit me up on my Twitter handle, hide@hide.com.
He didn't even
get up.
What just happened?
He just got you with his hand aids. You got too close.
His hand was already on the...
His hand was lava, bro.
The hand's hot lava.
Hand's hot lava.
This is fine. Everything's fine.
Hey, Nick, go wash the dishes. I'm pretty sure Mom needs them done.
All right, let's get... Get outfitted properly.
Use your giant laser death sword, whatever that is.
Yeah, I guess.
You're like, nah, I don't want to use that. I'm saving that for Ganon.
It breaks pretty quickly.
Oh, well, yeah, never mind.
And I kind of am saving it. Well, I'm not saving it for Ganon. I'm pretty far from Ganon. Because I explained earlier on the stream that I beat my personal game of this. I was too close when he stood up there.
To his foot. His foot also is lava, but now you know.
Yeah. Yep, now I know. I beat my personal game earlier this week and was nowhere near, you know, being completionist about it. So I decided that this game that I'm playing for the show, I'm going to, you know, stream for many, many weeks and get as close to 100% completion as I can. At least for the shrines.
Yeah.
Because there are 900 Koroks, so I'm not going to try to get all the Koroks because, good God. That's too many.
It could be
Koroks.
Worse, man. It could be over 9,000.
Too many Koroks. Too many Koroks. I feel like waking him up is actually a stronger plan right now.
So I'm noticing that some of your hearts are yellow. Is that because they have hepatitis?
Just jaundice.
It's jaundice. I guess that's what I should have gone with.
Well, hepatitis causes jaundice, so, you know, you're not wrong.
Step by step.
The,
I'm still not
the show
to
from TGIF with Patrick Duffy.
Yeah.
Okay, that does not do anything to him. Let's see if this works. Nope.
What is that? It's neat.
That's my thunderstorm rod.
Is he thunderstruck?
No, he has not been thunderstruck. That's the problem.
Oh shit.
No, regular arrows. Okay.
Try some different ACDC at him. Give him some dirty deeds.
Done dirt cheap?
Done dirt cheap.
Oh, nope. Run. Okay. This is fine. Why do I still have my stealth up? I'm gonna eat some attack foods.
Because it makes you more aggressive?
Yeah, it ups my attack power.
That's pretty awesome.
Yes! Okay. Landed it. Die faster! Die better! Run! Okay.
I'm trying to think of what food would make you do that, and all I'm coming up with is bath salts, and that's not technically food, but...
I'm using a weapon. I'm not chewing on his face. Oh, crap. Problem.
He's got wood, man. Watch it.
Yes! One slam. Oh, man, he gets up quick.
God, he just jiggles it at you.
It's a problem. I'm not going to lie. It's a problem. Oh, no! It's a problem! Okay. Woo, buddy. Okay. You're getting sleepy.
I'm not fully convinced he's getting sleepy.
Gets smart too, and he blocks his eye.
That son of a biscuit.
Damn it. Alright, I got him down like half. Got him to like half life.
I'd say even a third. Well, close to a third, not quite.
I was gonna say, if you want to like pull up
I'm
a chair instead of just kneeling.
Kneeling is not working out for me.
No! Okay. Yes! Okay! That's quick enough to get him in the eye. Die. Die. Crap, my sword broke. You're a quick weapon. Cha. Run! Okay.
Okay, now ladies.
Yeah?
You wanna know what time it is?
What time is it?
11:57. 12:57, but also it's what's cooler than being cool.
Sub-Zero.
No, it's ice cold, man.
Get over here. That's Scorpion.
All
right. Drop your hand. You got none, son.
How can he see you? He's running with... Oh.
Oh, my bow broke.
In mid-air.
Everything is the worst. Like, I'm so scared of...
I feel like you're taking him on, like, sort of an exercise regiment.
Yeah,
like, all right, run with me, man. We're going to lose you some weight and get you to that school dance.
Working on those LBs for him, son. Come on. Oh, no! I mean, this is doing... Oh, actually, that's doing a lot of damage. Yeah! Smart, not hard. Work smart, not hard.
Oh. If his body fell on him, he died.
Gotta get out of here. These are my eye holes. I gotcha, eye hole man. Big, fat eye hole man. All right. That was 3 of 3. That was the hardest one to beat. And what's that shiny thing? That's a leaf. Okay.
Is that just a trophy you get to carry around? Like, what is that?
That's it. The whole point of this was to get this shrine unlocked up here.
Ah.
Because you have to beat 3 of those guys. This guy was the hardest of the 3. But once you beat all 3 of them, each one has a ball. Yep, the old Lance Armstrong.
Joke.
Yes. thanks. Testicle joke, everyone.
Right
testicle
there.
Joke. So, then, boom, 3 out of 3. 3 out of 3 would beat up fat guys again.
I always check to make sure I've got all 3 of mine.
Well, yeah, that's... And
the Easter Island head just comes right out of the ground.
And then Hello. Speaks to it. Sup, brah?
You lift weights, bro?
Bro, do you even lift out of the ground and are made of stone? And, you know, Whatever.
The thing's mouth is so inviting.
Tawajin.
It looks like a little a weird distorted face.
Yeah, that's what all of them look like. Yeah. Get some nice Tawajin and some
juice.
Vermouth and gin and juice. Laid back. Wait. Laid back. With
I got my mind and my orca, or whatever that is in this game. Orca is a whale. Never mind.
Rupees. Rupees, perhaps.
Got my mind on my rupees and my rupees on my my pants. What?
Great Thunderblade. That's just great.
That is thundertastic.
And then, does this one have a bonus chest off to the side? No, some of them do. Also, this is what I love about the Switch right here. I can be like, boom, over here, just hanging out. Can't do that with normal controller. Can't do this crap. All right, so you explode, and give me my thing.
Sir,
and
you
then
look really hungry.
Yeah, it's like,
would you like some food?
Here, have a sandwich. You gave me your ghost ball, so you get a sandwich. Yeah, smile upon me, etc., etc. Sweet. All right, and it is right around 1 o'clock. We made good progress today. Once this loading screen finishes.
You got 3 balls.
Yeah, I got 3 balls. And I also got like 7 shrines, 8 shrines, 9 shrines, 10 shrines.
That's a lot of
shrines. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. Okay. That's neat. I'm going to save my game and then we're going to call it a day. So, yeah, everybody, thanks for watching. Come back next week. I'm going to keep playing this probably for the next several weeks. I'm going to be free next Sunday. So, I'll be streaming next Sunday, 11 a.m. to 1 Eastern Standard, Eastern Daylight, whatever
it
currently
is.
Ohio time.
Yep.
So, yeah. Bye, everybody. You want to say bye?
No, I was pointing. Yeah.